Okay, so today on section 9.5b, we are going to work on the direct comparison test. So we're going to have two series, A sub n and B sub n, be series with positive terms only. And of course, we have A sub 1 is less than or equal to B sub 1, A sub 2 less than or equal to B sub 2, A sub 3 less than or equal to B sub 3, and so on. So then we have two conditions here. If the series B sub n converges, it is going to force our smaller series to converge also. Likewise, if our smaller series A sub n diverges, then our bigger series B sub n diverges also. So let's try a couple examples. So 1 over 2 to the n plus 1. Okay, so with this series, it almost looks like it's geometric, but we have kind of this extra little plus 1 part to it. So because it's not as simple as we would like it to be, we will compare it to 1 over 2 to the n. Then the second thing you need to do is actually write out the inequality. So in this case, 1 over 2 to the n plus 1, the denominator is getting larger by 1, so therefore the fraction is getting smaller. So we're going to put a less than or equal to. Let's hope this series converges because it is the larger function. So let's now look at the series 1 over 2 to the n. What do you know about this series? Well, this is going to be a geometric series. We can actually write it as 1 over 2 in parentheses to the n power. Absolute value of r is equal to 1 half, which is less than 1. Therefore, it converges. So as our concluding statement here, we say, therefore, by the DCT, our series 1 over 2 to the n plus 1 converges also. Please make sure you guys have that last statement that you do say as your conclusion, because of the DCT, this series also converges. All right, let's try another one. Okay, now this time our series starts at 5, 1 over square root of n minus 2 from n equals 5 to infinity. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to choose something to compare it to. I'm going to choose to compare it to a simpler version of what we see, which would be 1 over square root of n. Our second step is to write the inequality. I'm going to have 1 over square root of n minus 2 and 1 over square root of n. So this is now greater than or equal to. We are going to hope that this series diverges. So let's take a look at that series on its own. 1 over square root of n from n equals 5 to infinity. That's really 1 over n to the 1 half power. This is going to be a p series. This is a p series with p equals to 1 half, which is less than 1. Therefore, the series diverges, and that's a good thing because look above, we wanted our series to diverge. So therefore, our final statement will be, therefore, by the DCT, this series diverges also. So let's try one more before we move on to our next test. 1 over 2n squared minus n. Let's compare this to 1 over 2n squared. So let's compare them. 1 over 2n squared minus n, and our other series, 1 over 2n squared. Again, our denominator is getting smaller, so our fraction is getting bigger. So we have this inequality. And on the right-hand side for this series, we are going to hope this series diverges. However, some of you guys may already be looking at it and be thinking otherwise. This series on the right-hand side, I could factor out the 1 half. This is a p series. However, p equals to 2, which is greater than 1, and our series is going to converge. The test fails. Now remember what it means for the test to fail. That means it's inconclusive, and we can't say, oh, okay, so I know it's going to diverge. No, that's not what it means. What we're going to have to do now is use what's called the limit comparison test. We have to have our two series have positive terms only, and this is where we're going to compare the ratios. If the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n over b sub n equals L, then both series will converge or diverge. So let's actually continue the problem that we were working on above and take a look at this. And I'm just going to continue it down here below. We were going to compare our series to 1 over 2n squared. So instead of our inequality, let's compare with the limit. So the limit as n approaches infinity of 1 over 2n squared minus n over 1 over 2n squared. Flipping the fraction, we have limit as n approaches infinity of 2n squared over 2n squared minus n. Because this limit is as n approaches infinity, we're only going to look at the higher power, so we can basically ignore the minus n, and we're going to get that this limit equals to 1. So once we get that limit equals to 1, we can say therefore, by the LCT, 1 over 2n squared minus n converges also, because we did already prove our other series, our known series, converged by the p-series test. So then we're done. So let's try one other example. Let's have n equals 1 to infinity of 6n to the fourth minus 2n cubed plus 1 all over n to the fifth plus n squared minus 2n. So this particular one, because of a bunch of minuses and pluses, it's pretty much impossible for you to be able to say you have some other series you're going to compare it to with either a greater than or a less than symbol. So we do have to start out with what we're comparing it to, which is going to be 6n to the fourth over n to the fifth, and then this simplifies nicely to 6 over n. I'm going to already say I know this is a p series with p equals to 1, or I can say this is a harmonic series. Do you remember that from before? This is a harmonic series which diverges. That is your proof in knowing just what the name of the series is. You can say it's a harmonic series, it diverges. Okay, so I'm going to do my limit, because now I got to show that they are behaving the same, so I have to take one series and divide it by the other. So that's going to be 6 over n. And notice when you're evaluating these limits, you ignore all the lower powers, so you're left with the sixes that cancel, and now you have n to the fourth, and another n on top cancels with the n to the fifth, and we get our limit equals to 1. Therefore, by the LCT, our series that we're trying to figure out, again, we have to write out the whole thing, diverges also.